Hey everybody, it's Berg, back at you with some more belt talk, and today, feast your eyes on this beauty right here, a new belt to the collection. That's right, this is the United States Heavyweight Championship title belt, the NWA US title belt. This belt was in use from 1985 to about 1990, and then was later replaced by the five-plate version of the United States title that you see here. But this belt, which is commonly referred to as the Luger belt, because Lex Luger was probably one of the more famed people to have held this belt, and his career is very synonymous with the United States title. This belt is, in my opinion, one of the best looking versions of the United States title. So let's take an up close and personal look at this belt here, give it a good once over, and we'll see what we're dealing with here.
All right, taking a closer look here at the NWA United States Championship belt. As I mentioned, this belt recently came into my collection, and I'm really happy about that because it's a beautiful belt. In my opinion, probably one of, if not the best version of the United States Championship title belt. If you haven't noticed already, the similarities between this and, say, the WWF Intercontinental title belt of the same era, you could probably see the similarities here with the stars and the banners, these columns. Very synonymous with the work of one Reggie Parks, the King of Belts. So very much a showpiece item. And again, like I said, just a very pretty belt overall. Now, this particular belt, I do not know who the maker is, but you can see on this leather strap here, it says what I believe is SM Leather. So I'm not sure who that is. The person I bought the belt from wasn't sure who the maker is or whose stamp that is on the leather. But regardless, I will tell you that the craftsmanship of this belt and the leather work is really, really nice. This is some very soft leather. The plates are very well done. These are 4 millimeter thick plates. The paint is very nice. Everything is just very well done on this belt. So very happy to have this belt in my collection and happy to be showing it off to you guys today. Let's take a quick look though. Left to right, top to bottom, front and back. As I mentioned, SM Leather on the stamp here. Very nice leather. Soft, pliable, floppy, whatever you want to call it. It's just very, very nice. Almost a premium leather in my opinion. You can see the edges are sealed and burnished. Some folks like that, some don't. I like it personally. And we've got very nice clamshell tooling that follows the border of the belt. One of the other things I like about the leather work is the embossed tooling here around the property plate. So this belt's got the NWA Globe property plate. And it just sits so nicely in that tool work there. The leather on this belt is sturdy enough to hold the belt upright for display purpose, or you can choose to display it with a belt stand. But again, very nice. We're going to flip it over here really quick and show you that the back of the belt is completely sealed. It's got a nice soft backing. All the screws are covered. And everything is very nice. So while this belt is commonly referred to as the Luger belt, it does date back to its debut, which I believe was with Magnum TA back in 1985. Magnum TA and Tully Blanchard had some great feuds. This belt also held by Barry Windham, another legend in the industry. But this belt was used up until 1990, and then it was replaced by the NWA five-plate version of the United States title belt. So when WCW was moving away from the NWA moniker, they commissioned new belts. And you'll see this belt as well in the style of Reggie Parks, with the banners, the stars, the columns, and the five-plate version, probably my favorite overall version of the United States titles. The plates on this belt, like I mentioned, 4 millimeter thick plates. Nice plating on this belt. The paint also pretty clean. You can see that this is, you know, just a very well-constructed, well-made piece. So taking a look at the side plates, you've got the grapplers with the shield. Moving over to the United States shield banner. Obviously our main plate, again, very synonymous with the work of Reggie Parks. So you got the stars, very similar to the IC belt in the WWF, the banners, the eagle. Again, Reggie just did incredible stuff. And mirroring the other side of the belt, the side plates over here also look great. And then we've got our property plate, which I love the property plate on the belts. Just as much as I love having a belt tip on the belts. So this belt obviously doesn't have one. I don't think the original version of this belt had a belt tip either. But to me, I just like belt tips. I think they give the belt a little bit more class. They add a little bit more weight, which I like. So no biggie that this belt doesn't have one. Again, checking out the leather work. Very soft. Nice leather. Again, the backing on this is very nice as well. Edges are all sealed and burnished. Very clean. A very nice example of what I think a belt should be. Anyway, guys, I hope everybody enjoyed this quick look at the United States Championship title belt. This belt, while it is currently in my collection, is destined for a new home. I'll be giving this belt to my brother, who I credit with getting me started watching wrestling and unfortunately getting hooked on wrestling belts, which my wallet now reminds me is maybe not the greatest thing. So, all right, everybody, thank you for watching. I will catch you for some more belt talk very soon. I am Berg, and we'll see you later.